the very best in professional wrestling, worldwide wrestling, David Crockett with Tony Schiavone. Tony, we have, again, the best hour in wrestling, the fastest hour in television.
There's no doubt about it, David. Wrestling fans all over the country watch us for a couple of reasons. Because of the very best in professional wrestling. Not only that, because we keep them up to date on what's going on in the world of professional wrestling. And a lot is going on this week.
Tony, that is correct. Because the championships, I'm talking about the World Tag Team Championship, the NWA Television Championship, the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship, they all, look at it, wait a minute. Good drop kick back. Pistol Pez Wally, and that's why they call him Pistol Pez. He's hot as a pistol. But let's get back to the championships, Tony. All right, the World Tag Team Championship. Hell by the... Oh, another good arm drag. Hell by the Raging Bull and Dusty Rhodes. They have been defeated.
That's right.
They're by new the Koloss. That's right. The Koloss are the new World Tag Team Champions. Oh! And really, with that, you have to include Crusher Khrushchev.
He's always around, David, but Ivan and Nikita Koloff are new World Tag Team Champions. But that's not all.
That's right. You think that's not enough? Tully Blanchard, the longest reigning NWA television champion ever, was defeated by none other than the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty Rhodes is the new champion. Also, the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion. We have a new one, Tony, and he is some man too.
You're talking about Avalanche Buzz Tyler, and he's going to be a fighting champion. There's no doubt about that. You'll see Buzz Tyler, the new Mid-Atlantic champion, defend that title many, many times.
That is right. All right, but we'll get to that later on. We've got it. One great match in there right now. Good arm drag again. Pez comes up with that arm bar. Holds it in tight. Remember, he's wrestling Hollywood Johnny Tatum. There you see Pez.
You know, David, it's good to see Pistol Pez Wally back here on Worldwide Wrestling. It's been a long time since we've seen this great athlete. And look at the size of this man. He is such a good athlete. And, of course, he has Hollywood Johnny Tatum. And so far, it's been a great match.
It really has. You see the best right here every week on Worldwide Wrestling. They all come because they know the best in the world is right here. All right, Tatum now. They're in the ropes. Catches Pez in the knee. He, again, in the midsection. Takes him, whips him across into the rope. Here comes off. Catches. Elbow right in that chest. Right. Tatum, he's feeling good right now. He's straightening his stuff, Tony. But the thing is, I think he gave Pez too much time.
You're right. Gave him too much time to get back and regain his composure. And I think we're seeing Pistol Pez now try to break out of the sleeper hold.
Pez catching the elbow in that midsection, knocks the wind out. Tatum comes right back. Rams his head in that turnbuckle. You know he's making a mistake now. Look at Pez. Right, here he comes.
Wrong move right there, David.
Look at Pez. Look at his eyes. Look at his eyes. Catches. Now Pez. With Pez, Tatum switches now. Comes off. That pin. All right, they come up. Tatum goes right in the eyes. Picks Pez up. Pez switches though. Backs him in the rope. Comes off. Try to roll up. Miss. And what's going to happen here? Headbutt! Wide headbutt! Drops down for the pin. He's got it, Tony.
You're right, David. There's your winner of our first match today, Pistol Pez Watley, and a flying headbutt executed off the ropes by Pistol Pez Watley over Hollywood Johnny Tatum. What a match. We'll see a portion of it in slow motion. Here comes Pistol Pez Watley, and down goes Johnny Tatum. David Crockett has Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll.
Ladies and gentlemen, with me right now, former NWA television champion, Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll. Mr. Blanchard, you've asked for this time. I know you have an awful lot to say.
Well, you know, David Crockett, you know, there was a lot of hoopla, a lot of build-up to Silver Star 85, March 16th, Greensboro Coliseum. And on that particular night, Dusty Rhodes defeated me right in the middle of the ring, 1-2-3, for the NWA Television Championship, ending the reign of the longest reigning television champion in the history of the NWA. You know, David, it takes a big man to come out here on national television and say somebody else was a better man and not make any excuses about it. But you know, Dusty, a lot of things were weighed in your favor. There was a lot of things on my mind. You had Baby Doll hanging from the ceiling. A lot of publicity about that. No disqualification, this, that, and the other. A lot of mind-boggling stuff which come out in the past. You are a master of psychology in professional wrestling. But you know, Dusty Rhodes, you being from Texas and me being from Texas, and you set out to come after me and take the NWA Television Championship away, which you did in 1985. That was your quest. Well, I'm setting out on a quest now, man to man, you and me, Texas style. Let's show the people from coast to coast what it's like to be in a Texas fight. Bunkhouse rules, but let's add a little Southern Texas flavor to it. My style. You know, you're from Austin where it's pretty and rolling hills and rivers and beautiful rolling scenery. But you know, I'm from South Texas where the mesquite trees and the longhorn cattle and the Santa Gertrudis cattle and the barbed wire marks off the sections of land. That barbed wire that tears people's skin. Well, Dusty Rhodes, you want to come bunkhouse style? I'll come bunkhouse style, but let's add that one flavor. Let's put that barbed wire up around that ring, and then we'll see once and for all who's the toughest man in professional wrestling, Dusty Rhodes or Tully Blanchard.
All right, you heard it from Tully Blanchard and Baby Doll. We'll be back with more action right after this. All right, ladies and gentlemen, in the ring right now, you're going to see some match. Arn Anderson against Steve Casey. Steve Casey, European heavyweight champion. You're going to see the American style, Minnesota Wrecking Crew style, I should say, against the European style wrestler. And there you see Arn Anderson. Now, Tony, trying to take over.
You know, David, you qualified that quite well, the Minnesota Wrecking Crew style, because Arn Anderson, the cousin of Gene Anderson and Ole Anderson, he claims now that Ole is here somewhere. He's claimed that, I think, every television program we've seen him, that Ole's going to be here, but I haven't seen Ole Anderson around at all, and I've been looking around, and he's easy to pick out in a group
of people. Yes, he is. Ole is definitely easy to pick out, but the thing is, you know, Arn Anderson keeps on saying that, you know, he's here or that he's got other commitments, that he can't come right now. You know, it could be that maybe Ole doesn't agree with Arn's style of wrestling.
That may be right.
His methods. But right now, Mr. Anderson has a definite challenge. With Steve Casey in that ring, this young man, he's destined to make it to the top. He's been doing very well, adapting to the American style of wrestling. Casey, a European style, does a lot of Greco-Roman wrestling, the upper part of the body. There you see now. He's got Anderson. Anderson trying to figure out how he's going to back out of it.
David,
Casey switches. Go ahead.
You mentioned the champions that we have on our program. Later on, very briefly, we'll tell the people. We'll talk to the new NWA television champion, the American Dusty Rhodes. You'll be talking to him later on. We have the new World's Tag Team Champions, Ivan and Nikita Koloff, with us. The Raging Bull and Magnum TA. The RPMs will be here. And then, David, it's Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant against superstar Billy Graham right here today on Worldwide Wrestling.
That is why, I know you might be getting tired of me saying it, but the best is right here, and we have it. You don't believe it? Just look, because it's great. Worldwide Wrestling, number one in professional wrestling. They issue two men right there. They're on the top. Arn Anderson, Steve Casey. Casey now has that headlock. He's willing to bide his time right now to wear Anderson down, and he needs to do that, because Anderson, you know, he's like a stick of dynamite. He has an explosion, but then you can wear him down, and that's what he's trying to do right now. All right, get back into the ropes. They come off. Oh, yes!
That shook him up, no doubt about it. Steve Casey back to the head. You know, David, Steve Casey's had a pretty good game plan coming in to this match, and so far he's been able to execute and hold on to that game plan to get a good look at Steve Casey holding on to Arn Anderson right there.
All right. You notice there, again, you know, like you said, that headlock. He's willing. He's cautious. He's not rushing into it. He's dictating the tempo of the match. And that means if he can continue, he's going to win this match, because the man that can control the match wins the match.
Yeah, that's right. That's what he has to do. He has to control the tempo. So far, Steve Casey has said, I want the tempo to be a little bit slower than usual. And that ended that.
Yes, it did. All right, there you see on the ring skirt, NWA. And that always means the major league professional wrestling, the very best. All right, Anderson comes out the road. Take the foot right into the chest again.
You know, David, both men are very deliberate in their style. However, their style's different so much, but they both go about it very, very slowly, very deliberately.
All right, Anderson, there you see, he just sort of sat on it. You can't pin Casey that way. You've got to tie that young man up. All right, Casey, up. Backdrop. Casey tried to catch himself, couldn't make it. Knocks the wind out a little bit. Again, Anderson, content. He's not going to be able to do it.
How about?
All right, there.
You know, now this is a surprise right here. This is really not like what we've seen of Arn Anderson in past matches to go to the head. He's usually just been coming in to kick, to stomp, to hurt somebody, and grabbing Steve Casey on the head. Now he's just asked referee Tommy Young to ask Steve Casey if he'd give up. Obviously he won't.
No, not that man. He comes right. Good, good. Backed out of it, went right to the arm. Now look at it. It bends him back.
Yeah, once again, a mistake on Arn Anderson's part, because that is not his style at all, at least it hasn't seemed to be.
Again, Casey is dictating the tempo of this match. He's controlling, even though he was in a predicament there. He's right out of it. I think Anderson is confused right now. Wait a minute, watch out. There he is.
I think everyone knew what was going to happen right there.
All right, Casey now. All right, now Anderson's making his own tempo. But he's taking his time. Got that knee across the throat. Breaks on that count. Again.
David, there's the Arn Anderson we all know. Stomping, pushing. That big elbow was quite an elbow on Steve Casey. Oh, look at that.
All right. About to crack a rib. Yeah, that's why. That is what made the Andersons famous. The Minnesota Wrecking Crew. Right, watch it, Casey. Bridging up. Can he just spin over?
It's going to take a powerful man to bridge up from that beating. Look at that. He won't go down.
No, he won't. He went at him the other direction, kicked him right in the kidneys.
Tell you what, you got to give Arn Anderson credit. He saw that Casey would not go down, so he came underneath and kicked him and set him right down again.
Anderson goes after that neck. But still, Anderson.
Keep it. Once again, it looks like it's Steve Casey's tempo.
Oh, yes, now Casey. Oh. Hey, this man can fight. Him in, whips it across, here it comes. Snapmare. Goes across, drops that leg across the chest, right of the head. Backs him in the ropes, whips him across again, cut him, catch it, and Anderson caught him. That elbow in the back of the neck. He's got him up.
Wow. My goodness, Arn Anderson wins once again, David Crockett. Very, very impressively also.
That's definitely an impressive win, because Casey is some wrestler.
Once again, we take a look at the winning move from Arn Anderson as he wins our second match of the day. And we remind you, coming up in just a few minutes, a talk with Dusty Rhodes, the new NWA Television Champion.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
NWA
It's a gigantic card, Greensboro Coliseum, Saturday, March the 30th at 8:15. On the card, Nature Boy, Buddy Landell, the RPM, Steve Casey, Pistol Pez Wally, a grudge match. Arn Anderson takes on the Region Bull. Special challenge match. The Barbarian goes after Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant. The Russian Mayor Ivan Koloff takes on Magnum TA in a lights out cage match. It's Wahoo McDaniel and Tully Blanchard with Baby Doll teaming up to take on the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and World's Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Earlier, we had a chance to talk to Tully Blanchard and Wahoo McDaniel, and let's hear what they had to say about this big night coming to the Greensboro Coliseum.
We're with Wahoo McDaniel, who's holding on to the World's Heavyweight title belt. Baby Doll and Tully Blanchard and all three of you seem rather dejected at this time.
Well, Tony, everybody that was at Silver Star 85 knows how Dusty Rhodes won and took my $10,000, and then they watched Wahoo McDaniels drag Flair, 1, 2, 3, 4. He is the World's Heavyweight Champion, and now the word comes across. The big challenge, Dusty Rhodes, Ric Flair, they want to challenge us to a war, put the steel cage up, and have a cage match against us?
Let me tell you something. Flair, you and Dusty don't have too good a sense. Now, I've got it on tape this time, Flair, and I took it away from you. But you want to get in the cage? Well, you've been in the ring with us twice, and neither one of you walked out. You just bring the cage, because we're not afraid of anything or anybody. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to keep this belt. You're going to have to come get it. You're going to have to take it away from me. And if it's in the cage, that's fine with me. Bring that big Dusty Rhodes with you. You won't walk out.
And tomorrow afternoon in Roanoke at the Civic Center, tomorrow afternoon beginning at 3 o'clock, a supercard of professional wrestling. On the card, Nikita Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev against the Raging Bull and Don Kernodle. Superstar Billy Graham takes on Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Viant. In a 20-minute match, Dusty Rhodes defends the TV title against Tully Blanchard with Baby Doll. And then Ivan Koloff will take on Magnum T.A. tomorrow, 3 o'clock in Roanoke.
You're a very foolish man, Magnum T.A., to sign a contract against Ivan Koloff in this Roanoke, Virginia. Tomorrow at 3 p.m., you're going to find out, like all the American people, why the Koloffs are World Tag Team Champion. Because we are the greatest athlete in the world. Tomorrow, you're going to find out at your expense. Can you imagine how you're going to feel, Magnum T.A.? After match is over, you're going to be laying there hurt, and all the girls are going to be around you crying. Oh, Magnum, poor Magnum T.A. But it's going to be too late for you, American. Too late.
I give you the NWA television champion, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. They love you.
That's it. You know, traveling all over this country and being able to say that Baby Doll and Tully Blanchard are no longer the NWA television champion is a big thrill. I mean, we took it to the limit. I mean, Baby Doll, she went up high in this cage. It was a good thing she didn't have a dress on. So, oh, Lord, I just don't even think about what would have been going on. But I got to say one thing, and one thing is for sure. Right now, I'm holding what once belonged to Tully Blanchard, and there's no way in the world he ever gonna get it back. Ever gonna get it back. Every man, woman, child sitting out there, every race, creed, and color travels all over this country knows one thing, that Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, when it came down to it, even though my mama got mad at me, I just slapped her face when it got time. And I apologize. I want to ask all the ladies in just a minute a question right now. We're taking a look at film right here from Silver Star, where Dusty Rhodes became the NWA television champion. And right here you see Tully Blanchard going down in defeat to the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Now, then, they took upon themselves to mess up my whole evening. They made me real angry because Wahoo McDaniel brought upon himself to come in and take care of business. Right here you see me parading around in my glorious style as a new NWA television champion. Now, then, you're going to see Tully Blanchard, Wahoo McDaniel, they're ganging up on me, they hit me, they're punching me, they're kicking me, they both got me down. But not for long, because one thing happened to me that night. One of the greatest athletes in this country, bar none besides the American Dream, even though I want what he's got, is Nature Boy Ric Flair. And on this occasion, he chose to come down and try to help out. You see the cage being lowered right here. Baby Doll, 20,000 feet in the air she was. Couldn't even smell her, much less see her. And right here you're going to see Tully Blanchard run my head. And my cage's name, by the way, is Betty Lou. And Betty Lou going to come out again sometime and take care of business. But right here you see what Ric Flair and what kind of man he is. Wahoo McDaniel, you got to deal with Ric Flair. You got to deal with Dusty Rhodes. You got the two best right there, Daddy. So let's take Wahoo McDaniel. Let's take Tully Blanchard. Let's put them in a cage and let me and Ric Flair just get down to kicking their booty somewhere in this country. And then me and Ric Flair take care of our own personal business. And you know what that personal business is. It's the world's heavyweight title. I'm proud of this thing. Like I said, I want to ask all the ladies out there, and I want all the ladies just to listen to this. I know I was wrong when I slapped Baby Doll. I know that. No. Shh. But I want to ask you, am I forgiven? I mean, I want to hear, am I forgiven? Yeah, I know it. Lord bless my soul, my mama said. You know what? Be good to your mama, because you only got one. And love your daddy. And most of all, Tully Blanchard, I got what belongs to you, daddy, and you can't have it. I love you, baby. Bye-bye.
That's it. That's the dream. We'll be back with more right after this. Ladies and gentlemen, with me right now, the world six-man tag team champions and also the world tag team champions. Now, Mr. Koloff, I see you smoking your cigars. Who are the tag team champions? I noticed that Nikita and Crusher Khrushchev were. But somebody told me that you and... Who is?
Crocker, just shut up for a minute and I'll explain to you. Being world six-man tag team champion and now being world tag team champion, it is any combination of the three of us. Any two of us can defend belts at any time. Because now we are truly the world champion. You are looking right, the combination of the three of us. The Sergeant Slaughter, this Magnum TA, and Canoodle. Yes, they won the battle against the flag. They have the American flag back. But we won the war, because as you can see, Crusher Khrushchev and our nephew Nikita's ways, we have world tag team belts. And we are challenging every team out there. I know they're all going to be getting together to try to come up against us and try to take away. Can you imagine this American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and this Raging Bull right now are planning strategy to try and get back belts? We know that all the competition in NWA is greatest in all the world. This is why we are here, to prove why the Russian athlete is number one. But we don't feel this American Dream and this Raging Bull should get a chance against the belt. We have proven we are far superior, and I am still suffering bruises all over my body from this match to gain world tag team belts. So I don't feel this should give title shot. We are going to give shot.
This American Dream, this Raging Bull, how you say, all around. History of the level is there no more.
History.
Koloff, Khrushchev, take all competition and go down.
We don't have to say anything. Just listen. Ladies and gentlemen, you fans out there, there's only one reason there is so much hate in the world.
That's not the reason.
That's not the reason, because that's why there's so much pride in the world. The United States. Those three men over there now. The Russians. Ivan Koloff, Nikita Koloff, and Crusher Khrushchev.
David's going up against Sam Houston and Gene Leggett, and Sam Houston working on Ivan Koloff to start off this match.
Koloff catches it with that boot. They are now the world's six-man tag team champions, plus the world tag team champions. And like they said, they can truly say they are the world champions.
No doubt about that. You know, David, it brings up an interesting point, too, because
just before this match started, you had a chance, of course, to talk to the Koloffs and Khrushchev. Nikita Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev are wearing those belts. Now, we understand Ivan Koloff and Nikita Koloff won the tag team titles of the world. Legally, now, can Crusher Khrushchev be in there and defend that tag team title?
They say they can. They say they can switch off. They can switch around. That since they are the world six-man tag team champions plus the world tag team champions, they can do... Look at that! Nikita Koloff! The might of this team. I mean, this man is built. He is strong. Throws Houston right outside the ring.
You know, David, one thing's for sure, though, regardless of who defends the belts, you always have to contend with all three of them.
Yes. The Koloffs, they're a machine. They're a machine that tries to cave the chest in. They want to do only one thing. They want to destroy. And that's what they're trying to do to Houston right now. Houston catches Nikita. Tries to knock the wind out of him.
Not even phasing him, I don't think. Look at that.
All right, Nikita whips that neck back. The neck. That shows you how strong he is. Just the neck. Catches Sam Houston now. The master, the coach, the professor, Nikita, Ivan. But he misses. All right, now. Ligon comes in. Ligon catches him right to left. Backs him in the rope. Whips him across. Let's see what happens now. Back up. Ivan quickly gets up, though. Again, into the ropes. I knew it. Never go twice to the well.
That's right. Two time is unlucky for Gene Ligon, because now he is in the wrong cutter to be with the world tag team champions, the brand new ones, working on Gene Ligon.
Right now, Ivan goes, starts stomping on Ligon. Snapmare throws him over. Tags Houston. Houston comes in. Houston tries his best to stop Ivan. Uh-oh. Here comes the tank. Nikita, look at this. Look at us. Just the sheer might of this man. The rage. Wait a minute. Here it comes.
There it was, David. The Russian sickle off of the top rope. And that's curtains.
That is definitely it. And there you see them strutting around in all their glory. The Koloffs and Crusher Khrushchev. Now, Tony, watch what they do.
It's what they call the Russian sickle out of the top rope. We'll let the fans see it themselves. And remind you that coming up next, a talk with Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant, and you'll see Magnum TA in action. Don't go away.
I think the happiest man in the world is with me right now. I'm talking about the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vance. Jimmy?
Oh, mercy! The Boogie Man and his old lady is happy today, baby. You know, the old lady, this is my main old lady now. My main old lady, she's never away from my side. I eat with her, I sleep with her, and I take her for a long ride every single night. Now, I introduced Paul Jones to my main old lady. Now, I want to show all my brothers and sisters, when I came back, I said I was going to hug Paul Jones. Me and my main old lady, let's take a look.
All right, there you see right now, Paul Jones is going after Dick Slater and his men. I'm talking about superstar Billy Graham plus the Barbarian now. All three men pounding away on him.
Show got that right, brother. This is what I'm talking about. When I came back in, I said, Paul Jones, I will hurt you. Paul Jones at this second is in a hospital, people. Brothers and sisters, listen at me. He's in a hospital. His whole shoulder is torn out. His arm is broken. Look at the Boogie Man. Workout. Workout time, baby. Woo, I feel good, brother. I love to hit somebody right now.
Home run, man.
Oh, this is it. This is a grand slam right there, brother. Oh, yeah. I'm not done. Keep your eyeball on the bat, Jack. Right there. Woo, mercy. The Boogeyman feels good. I love it to death. You know something, baby? There's some more people I know. You know about baseball. All the people know about my baseball. Well, I want to tell you something. In baseball, you get three balls thrown at you, and you see if you can hit them. Well, the first ball I want thrown at the Boogeyman is Kabuki. And when I get Kabuki like this, Jack, oh, wow. It's a home run, you understand? Watch it, David. I ain't gonna hit you in a little backlash. And the second ball I won is the Barbarian, and I'm gonna hit him over the fence. And the third ball is gonna be Superstar Billy! And then you know what it is? Three strikes and you're out. You're all out, Jacka!
All right, let's go to the ring now. And Magnum, T.A., and the Raging Bull against RPM. Tony, what about that man?
I don't know what to think of him. I tell you what, though, he certainly did do a number on Paul Jones just like he promised all the fans that he would.
That is right. And you know, he was talking about he was going to get Superstar Billy Graham.
Well, have his chance, isn't he?
Coming up next, Jimmy Vance against Superstar Billy Graham, right here on Worldwide Wrestling. You only see the best, the very best. NWA Wrestling, the Major League of Professional Wrestling, in the ring right now. The RPMs.
That's LP in the ring right now against Magnum TA. LP and DJ, the RPMs. And, of course, this is going to be a great tag team match.
Oh, yes. Good tackle. Good tackle now. Drop down now. Scoop him up for that slam. Has him. Right down the small of the back. Another slam here. Catches him. Ah, Magnum. Look at him. He's ready.
You know, the thing that separates Magnum TA from the rest of the wrestling world is that he has a temper that is second to none, but he can control that temper enough.
He can?
To use it to his advantage in the match.
Yes. Use it. I mean, he gets mad in a, you know, less David, than a second.
Yeah, you talk so many times on this program about being out of control. Even when he's at his maddest, he is really never out of control. And that's good for him.
Yes, it is. And they're in that corner. Catch him with the right hand. Whips him across. Switch now. Into that turnbuckle hard. Oh, high! That back drop. Audible catches him with the right hand. I just couldn't help it. He was throwing his hand up to wave him off.
That's right.
But there, look at that Magnum. Look at that man. All right now.
There's DJ reeling from those blows. Very flamboyant, the RPMs, Dave.
Yes, they are.
Now the Raging Bull, Matty Fernandez, formerly half of the NWA World Tag Team Champions, and, of course, a fine partner to have in the ring.
Oh, yes. The Raging Bull, a great veteran, wrestling and veteran of Vietnam. This man, he's been through it all. Look at him. Now you talk about another man that can control his anger. You know he is ready. Look at him. Go back. There you see. The Raging Bull. They're staring each other down. Headlock now. Bull now. Sticks that arm in. Position. Backs him into that rope. Hey, come off. Drop down now. Over. I thought he almost missed it. Again. Over. Why? Great. Stop him. Look at.
Nope.
I don't blame him. I would back off too.
DJ's not going to go in there, and you see LP getting up. I tell you what. We talked about the self-proclaimed Kung Fu champion of the world, Superstar Billy Graham, but this guy, the Raging Bull, knows a lot of Kung Fu and karate himself.
Yes, he does. Raging Bull, besides that, he just knows how to fight. Good job. Chops him to the chest, knocks him down. Makes that tag a man. DA, he's up on that second rope. Oh, our fans love it. They love these two guys. Drop that leg across the arm. Still, remember, same thing with the arm. All right, takes him up, makes that tag. What's he gonna do? Up. Second rope, Tony, here it comes. Hard leg. Oh, the force he comes off on that arm. Twist. Tag again. Teamwork.
Absolutely.
Again, right across that arm.
David, you said it quite well right there. Teamwork, and I mean teamwork second to none right here. Won't even let him in his corner.
DJ trying to make that tag, but all right, the Bull's in. Oh, kicked him that time. Kept that foot high in the air, right under the arm, twisting slowly but surely. You know the bull is enjoying this right now. All right, they're in the ropes. They're in the ropes. Referee trying to call for the break. Cross. All right, DJ, drop down. Tackle. Called both men.
Certainly did. The bull came out on the top of that one, though. Right up against the chest.
No.
You can hear DJ say, no, I don't give up yet.
DJ going after the eyes. That's the only way you could get out of it now.
The bull had gone to the wrong corner, David. He thought Magnum TA was there, but unfortunately it was LP, and now the RPM's taking control.
All right, cross into the ropes.
Cut it!
The elbow right in the center of the chest. Picks him up. Slams the bull. Goes down. You can't pin the bull that way, boy.
Only a one count. Absolutely right.
All right, pounds on the back. The RPMs, it looks like they're just trying to maul him. Can he do it? Oh.
Trying to fight out of this, David.
Trying to find him. Here he goes. Hard slam. Got it in. All right, now they're trying to hold him down, Tony.
No doubt about it. They're trying to slow down the match right here, David. Take better control of it. I don't know. The bull will have a chance to come back from this.
Let's see what happens. The fans are behind him, and that counts a lot. It definitely counts a lot. Headbutt! All right, let's see what happens now. Make the tag to Magnum. Magnum, look at him. He's ready. He backs him in. Whips him across. Catching him. Will the RPM try to come in, but Magnum caught him too. Now all four men are in the ring. They start pounding away.
Both those now, David. Look at the RPMs. Oh, no.
Look at that switch. Beautiful.
That's it.
Definite teamwork. Fantastic.
It was the belly-to-belly suplex that executed the pin as Magnum TA and the Raging Bull, Matty Fernandez, are your winners in this sensational tag team match. We are going to see the switch executed by both men, and then in just a moment, you'll see the belly-to-belly suplex as Magnum TA and the Raging Bull, Matty Fernandez, are your winners.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area.
Worldwide Wrestling salutes its Station of the Week, WPWR Chicago, and Program Director Neil Saban. Greensboro Coliseum, Saturday, March the 30th at 8:15, a supercard of professional wrestling with Nature Boy Buddy Landell, Avalanche Buzz Tyler, Pistol Pez Wally, Arn Anderson takes on the Raging Bull, a special challenge match, the Barbarian against Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vian, and a Lights Out cage match. Listen to this. It's Wahoo McDaniel and Tully Blanchard with Baby Doll against World Heavyweight Champion Nature Boy Ric Flair and Television Champion, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Earlier, we had a chance to talk to Ric Flair and Dusty Rhodes about this gigantic card. Let's go to that right now.
The two biggest attractions in the world of sports are standing side by side. World Heavyweight Champion Nature Boy Ric Flair and NWA Television Champion, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
You know, this means a tremendous lot to Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. And standing here next to Ric Flair is the greatest two wrestling professional athletes in this country and this sport today. And let me tell you something. Why don't we quit messing around, Wahoo McDaniel, Tully Blanchard? Put it in a cage, a steel cage, right here, Daddy, and see who the better men are. Let's have a war if you want a war. Right, Ricky?
You forget about who the biggest attractions are. That's already established. We want to find out just who the two best men are. The cage is up. You accepted a Wahoo, you accepted a Blanchard. The difference is this time, it's 2-on-2. The Dream and I don't get along with each other, but we respect each other. And brother, in the cage, We're going to take Tully Blanchard and Wahoo apart. Woo!
And at the Roanoke Civic Center, a gigantic card. Tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock in Roanoke, you'll see Arn Anderson, Nature Boy Buddy Landale, Pistol Pez Watley, Nikita Koloff, and Crusher Khrushchev take on the Raging Bull and the Pride of the USA, Don Kernodle. It's superstar Billy Graham against Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vian. Also a 20-minute match for the television title. Dusty Rhodes defends against Tully Blanchard. And then you'll see Ivan Koloff take on Magnum T.A. tomorrow at 3 p.m.
You know, tomorrow I have the opportunity of a lifetime. Now, people all know I've been concentrating all my energy on going after Wahoo McDaniels from the United States City weight title, but now I've got a chance to go out there for all the people in America and go out there against the senior member of the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff, and take him on head-to-head, nose-to-nose, just him and I. Now, you always talked about Russian superiority, Ivan. You always said how you're all so much better. Well, show me tomorrow what you got. Show me how you're so much better, because I'm red, white, and blue, through and through, and Magnum T.A. is coming there tomorrow to show you American superiority. You're going down Magnum T.A. style. Tomorrow, you're mine.
Superstar Billy Graham, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vang, bang, goes right after him.
Oh, no, David.
He has a camera cable.
Oh, I know our cameraman's got to go with him now. They go right in. There he is, handsome Jimmy Vang. He's already got rid of Paul Jones. He's going after Superstar Billy Graham. Takes him across, whips him. Catch it, sleeper! Sleeper has got a lock! Jimmy Vann's got that sleeper lock, Tony.
Already, David, he's trying for a very quick win against one of the legends of professional wrestling, Superstar Billy Graham. Let's see if he can get it done.
He's in the center of that ring. Graham trying to hold on. Vann. Kenny. Oh, he wraps it out again. He's got that sleeper locked in tight. Graham trying to get to the ropes. He's just inches away. There you see him. So close. Can he make it to the ropes? He's trying. Just about there, Tony.
He's about 4 inches away now from that rope. Getting very close.
He's about out. Can he make it?
This may be it, David. This may be the end of the match. It may go this quickly.
Oh, no. He made it. Makes it just in time. There you see him. Referee's calling for the break. Bam breaks just in time. And he's talking. Look at the tape. He's got that tape. Bam starts to pound away. Backs him in. Whips him across. Elbow. Van comes off again. Drops the elbow across the chest. Drops the elbow again. Drops it again. Here they come! Here they come! Kabuki the Barber! The Barbarian is using the savant kick on Jimmy Vann. Now all three men, Superstar Billy Graham, the Barbarian, Kabuki, start to pound away on Jimmy Vann.
This has to be retaliation for what happened to Paul Jones.
Look out! Here it comes! Hang on, people!
It's Pistol Pez Watley, Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, Avalanche Buzz Tyler. Magnum T.A. is there. Also the Raging Bull. They all come in as Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant wins the match by disqualification because the Barbarian and the Great Kabuki both came in to help out superstar Billy Graham. Oh my, checking now on the Boogie Woogie Man to see if he's okay. All four men, as you can tell, looking down on him. I don't know, there's a good shot of him trying to regain his senses as he was absolutely ambushed. He's coming up. And there he is. It was an array of elbows that led to the ambush. As you see, the Barbarian now in the ring. And just a minute, the Great Kabuki. But the winner by disqualification, Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, with me right now, J.J. Dillon.
David Crockett, Eddie, this is the most exciting hour on television. I've never seen so much pandemonium fill in the arena in my life. I see title change in hand. They're talking about new TV champions, new world tag team champions. They're talking about challenges being issued. They're talking about barbed wire, things that I never even imagined, let alone heard of in the past. But David Crockett, the most exciting thing on this hour of television has yet to happen yet, because I'm talking about the Nature Boy, Buddy Landell, standing right to my side, the hottest thing that Los Angeles, California has ever produced, my boy. Tell them.
You know, David Crockett, they say, why do you call yourself the Nature Boy? Well, I'll tell you. When you can hit a ball over the ballpark, they call you Babe Ruth. And when you can take a football and throw it the length of the football field, they call you Joe Namath. Woo! And when you can get down and you can make better love than James Bond, they call you the Nature Boy, and that's exactly what I'm talking about. The girls know what I'm talking about. JJ knows what I'm talking about. JJ, tell them about it, brother, while I sit here and call
him. Wow, he's so pretty. You know, they talk about charisma. You talk about what's happening. This man is what happened. You need more time on the show.
Worldwide Wrestling is a presentation of the JCP Sports Network and has been furnished to the station for broadcast at this time in exchange for commercial consideration.